In this video, we'll present the new enhancements of the Scheme Setting user interface. Open the document, Schedules and Lists, Schedules, Scheme Settings menu command, or right-click on the Schedules in the Navigator to open the Scheme Settings dialog. By clicking the New button, the Add Schedule Scheme dialog appears. Here we can add the ID and the name of the new scheme. By clicking the pop-up, we can also select the schedule type to associate it with. The duplicating function has been combined into this dialog for better consistency. Select the Duplicate Radio button, and from the pop-up you can choose the scheme that you're going to duplicate. Let's select the Finish by Elements now. Click OK. As a new enhancement, the Scheme Settings list now has resizable and clickable headings to sort by ID or name. Collapse the Scheme panel now. Click the Add button in the Criteria panel. As you can see, the criteria list is extended with more items. For example, surface-related parameters are available as well. The different types are divided with separator lines for better visibility. Open the Fields panel now. This list now supports multi-row selection, which allows multiple removal, dragging, and editing of rows. You will also notice that the Select All shortcut is now also supported. The sorting buttons are also active, which means we can switch, for example, the sum for all items at the same time. As you can see, the additional parameters have been moved to a sub-dialog and now adds an instant search and list view. In the tree view, we can find the different types of elements. Surface-specific parameters are available as well. By clicking the Search button, the Search dialog appears. Here we can sort the parameters by group or field. We can also enter any parameter in the search field to search for. Let's enter the keyword color now. As you can see, all the color-related parameters have appeared. Select these two items and click Add. Now they're a part of the fields list. The three-dot button to the right of the exposed area line brings up the Reduced Area dialog box. This dialog box can be used to narrow the definition of what counts as exposed when listing exposed area in a surface schedule.